All right, now in this video, we're going to talk about the thyroid gland. It's very rare to have a primary thyroid problem. Maybe if you live in an area where there's no iodine, you can have a thyroid problem, but it's just really rare. So what you want to do if you have thyroid symptoms, which are hair loss, dry hair, slow metabolism, loss of eyebrows right here, weight gain all over the place, and abnormal thyroid hormones and blood tests, then you're going to look at three different areas for the root cause, and you're going to work on whatever shows up on that, and then recheck your thyroid, and you're going to find your thyroid will start to come back. Now, there's a case that you may have had your thyroid removed or partially removed, and then you're going to need to take the medication, but still it's necessary for you to isolate what the trigger was for the original problem in the first place. But let's just talk about the primary causes of thyroid issue. Number one, the liver and gallbladder. If 80% of the thyroid is converted from T4 to T3 through the liver and the gallbladder. So T4, T3 represents the number of iodine molecules. So T4 is inactive thyroid, so it really doesn't do anything if it's in the blood. That would be something like Synthroid, the medication. But then, the liver converts, it takes iodine off and it becomes a T3, and that's an active form, and that's where it does the work. So if you're taking thyroid hormones but you're still tired, you're still cold feet, cold hands, etc., it just could be that's not converting. So if you have any number of liver symptoms, bloating, burping, belching, right shoulder pain, headaches, any of the fat-soluble vitamin deficiencies in the other video that we talked about, it could mean that the gallbladders, you need some gallbladder formula support to be able to give you the bile support to convert this, and then let's see if your thyroid kind of comes back to normal. All right? So that's number one. Number two would be of the adrenals. Adrenals can cause the thyroid to not work, but the way it does it, it creates an autoimmune disease. Now, what is an autoimmune? It means that your own thyroid is attacking itself. All autoimmune diseases are triggered by some stress. If you ask anyone with an autoimmune, ask them when it occurred and exactly what happened, it was after some stress event. It could be pregnancy, it could be divorce, or whatever. So that stress shocks the different parts of the body and you create an autoimmune. So there's two main autoimmune diseases with thyroid. There's one where the thyroid hormones are too high. It's hyperthyroid, that's called Graves. And then there's a hypo, which is too low, and that's called Hashimoto's. But both of them are triggered by stress. So the only thing you want to do for that, if the person either has their thyroid left, or you have your thyroid, or don't have your thyroid, is you want to do this. Like, how do you get rid of autoimmune? There's something you can take, it's called a PMG. It's called a protomorphogen, don't worry about the name. It's basically, it's kind of an extract from a thyroid gland, from the DNA, and you take it orally. You take one of these, and the remedy you take is called thyrotrophin. PMG. You can get it from Standard Process. I think you even buy it online, because they're selling it all over the place. You can probably get it from Amazon.com. Thyrotrophin. So if it's autoimmune, you take one thyrotrophin PMG before you go to bed. What happens, it goes into your body, in your stomach, and there's all these lymph nodes in your stomach. And these antibodies that are attacking and destroying your own thyroid will go, whoop, zzz, phew, goes right to your stomach instead of your thyroid. It acts as a decoy. So therefore, you can then deplete all the stored antibodies that are attacking your body over to this decoy in your stomach and eventually have the thyroid actually heal up. So that's one remedy for autoimmune, whether it's hyper or hypo. Even if you had it removed, you still want to do it because there's antibodies sitting there. That's just one thing. So, and then support the adrenals. Do things for the adrenal support. That's in a different video, but I just want you to think with the information and not be robotic about it. Okay, so that's number one. Number one, you do the gallbladder formula. Number two, you do thyrotrophin, PMG, and adrenal support. and eliminate the trigger and stress. And three is the overactive ovary. The ovaries produce a lot of estrogen. If the person is estrogen dominant, they're pumping out too much estrogen, and you can tell that by their periods. The periods are crazy heavy, bleeding, cramping, irregular, infertility, PMS, or they had a pregnancy, or they have a fibroid, all these things. All that extra estrogen can act as a mimicker of the thyroid hormone. So estrogen can block the receptors for the thyroid hormone. So they can fit in there like a lock and a key and lock up the gland so the thyroid can't go in the receptors to do its job. So estrogen inhibits the thyroid function over time. It blocks it, it prevents it from working. So increase estrogen, decrease thyroid function. Okay? So if that's the case, so what you're doing is you're scanning your body and figuring out, do I have more digestive issues? Do I have autoimmune? Do I have a period issue? Okay, let's say it's a period issue. Then we want to support the ovary with something called ovary support formula and cruciferous food, because cruciferous is anti-estrogenic and that will clean all this up. So I know some people say don't take cruciferous with thyroid because it pulls out iodine. Well, I put sea kelp back into that product so there won't be any loss of iodine. So it's real simple. We find out which it is and then we work on that primary area so your thyroid can come up. But we're still not done yet. We're going to apply acupressure. So in the next part, I'm going to show you to do acupressure for the thyroid. And it's very powerful. So that way you've exhausted all the different techniques to improve the thyroid function. This, I'm trying to make this as simple as possible. Now, you might have, oh my gosh, I have all these problems. I have a liver problem, I have a gallbladder problem, I have adrenal problem, I have estrogen. Then you might need to work on each one of them. In some of the other videos, I'm going to kind of help you show you what causes what so you can think with it. But again, I'm trying to take a complex subject and make it very simple. I hope this gave you some basics on what to do, and just look at 1, 2, 3 and see what would affect the thyroid.